To that end, let me show you a slide that I have been using for years in my History of Barbershop course. It lists properties that seem to me to be common to barbershop of all ages. The top first one talks about the harmony, that it is consonant, it is four-part, it is a cappella, and I say all of these should be preceded by the word primarily. Barbershop has not been strictly a cappella from its beginning. It is primarily a cappella. In its purest form, it's a cappella. Solid voicings, harmonic variety, and few passing tones, meaning not many notes that don't fit into the chord. All barbershop seems to me to possess that. Secondly, the melody's in the second tenor. There's a first tenor above. Bass filling in on solid chord tones and baritones filling in what is left. I have seen many kinds of music, vocal and instrumental, and I have never seen anything in music like the barbershop baritone part.
You're here.
There's nothing that abandons normal voice leading like barbershop baritone. I see that in no other kind of music. That alone identifies barbershop uniquely by itself. You don't have to go any further than that. And it's just as alive today as it ever has been. Third, embellishments continually converging to homophonic chords. Homophonic, nothing to do with your sexual preference. It simply means that everybody's singing the same thing at the same time, except a lot of times in barbershop we're not. To have any kind of embellishment, you're not. Old barbershop was full of non-homophonic, but it converged to the homophonic at the end. And those old harmonizers on the streets of New York ended the phrase with a good chord, and they say, we cracked up a chord right there. Freedom with the song, always and ever. Even generations of barbershop that said, oh no, we're preserving the song, we're distorting the song beyond the composer's recognition. Take a song like, Who'll Take My Place When I'm Gone? I guess that was written in the era where you had to use the composer's melody, and I guess it does, but that's the only thing the composer gave it that was preserved. It distorts the song and the rhythm beyond the composer's recognition. The song was written as a foxtrot, for goodness sakes. It doesn't sound anything like what was written. Barbershoppers from day one have taken freedom with the song. That's an inherent part of the style, just as much with barbershop as it is with jazz. Thirdly, chords tuned with an ear towards lock and ring. Going back to the earlier guys that cracked up that chord, it's always had a penchant for the lock and ring. Now, that doesn't mean we always succeed, and I hesitate to put that on the list simply because I never want qualitative things to be on a list that's a definition. I fought off for years and years, we used to have an arrangement category that always wanted to have qualitative things in the definition, like barbershop has tasteful embellishment. No, barbershop has embellishment. We've got to allow it to be bad and still be barbershop. Not all jazz has tasteful embellishment, but it's still jazz. So I don't mean to write a qualitative. That's not, we always succeed. That doesn't mean if you're out of tune, it's not barbershop. It means that that's our goal. It's always done. The music is with an ear towards lock and ring. And of course, that entails harmonies that lock and ring. Okay. You will note there's nothing up there about chord progressions, form, types of songs, when a song was written, or vocal style. That's because none of those things seem to be common throughout our past. Now, certainly our contest rules are entitled to be more specific in order to present what is most typical, and that is perhaps appropriate. We'll leave that to the contest and judging people to decide. And let me just say that I love the contests. Been going to contests, participating in them since I joined barbershop. And I've been going to the contests of Sweet Adelines. I've been married to that organization for almost 30 years. And Harmony Incorporated. And I love the differences that exist. I don't always agree with theirs, don't always agree with ours. I might have chosen a different winner just like you. But still, we appreciate the effect that this has on our style. It has a positive, consolidating effect, keeping our style of music centered, and that's a good thing. But let us not equate contest suitable with barbershop. Otherwise, much of our formative music is excluded. The barbershop style and culture includes the contest, but it is bigger. And let me emphasize that though these characteristics allow a good deal of latitude, they uniquely define barbershop harmony. There is no other style that has them, and hardly any that comes close. As we face the future, I say let's take pride in this style of music with these simple characteristics, and let's carry it forward. And let's hang on to even our name, the term barbershop. I think it has great meaning. And I've heard a few suggest that, well, since our music doesn't sound like it used to, we might as well just call it a cappella. But general a cappella doesn't have those features. It does not. Start listening to it and observing. Barbershop is a term that reflects these features as well as our racially diverse roots, beginning with those humble singers that harmonize in the barbershop. It carries our past with it, and we should apply it to what we sing today and will sing in the future, as well as for all the variations sung by other generations since the beginning. Let us embrace the past and embrace the future.